Hello guys, and welcome to the 5th episode of the Cura Advanced Settings 2019 here at Architects 3DP. In the last episodes,
we started studying the custom settings section that I'm gonna open right now and analyze the first tab, quality. Today we're going to keep studying the custom settings menu, but in this case, we're gonna analyze the shell tab, a very interesting one that you should pay attention to get better results in your prints.
But before starting, be sure to click here in the subscribe button and to ring that bell to be notified when new cool stuff is uploaded. If you do it, it will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you.
Well, so once in the custom settings menu, I'm going to open the shell tab. Remember that we are in the profile we created last week that we named Architects 3DP i3 2019. Alright, so inside the shell tab, we can see that in this case we can only see the wall thickness setting.
Not much to explain here, since it will control the thickness of the perimeters of our prints, but it is very important that you have in mind the thickness of the nozzle you are using, since this value should be a multiple of the nozzle diameter.
Once set, as we can see, the thickness is set to 0.8, what means that using a 0.4mm nozzle as we do, the number of perimeters will be 2.
Alright, so we are done for this tab and this video, guys. No, I'm kidding.
As always, we're going to go to the setup wheel and we're gonna display some more interesting parameters.
Disclaimer here, that's my personal setup. It doesn't mean it is the best for every case, but I think it's a pretty good configuration to go with if you want.
Well, actually I'm going to go back and drop in the canvas an STL model, that in this case is going to be this really cool Mickey Mouse 3D model created by Gabriel Martini, and I downloaded it from my mini factory. I will let you the link in the description to download it. As you can see, I dropped the model and shows perfectly here in the Prepare tab, but if we go to Preview, it won't automatically slice. To slice it, we'll have to click here in the Slice button. This is because I've deactivated the Auto Slice option, that you can find going to Preferences, Configure Cura, and deactivate in the first click. By the way, a really cool option I like to activate too is this one called Center Camera when Item is selected. You can copy it if you want.
Having this slice automatically option deactivated will speed up the whole process if you don't have a very capable PC. I'm using an i7-6700K at 5GHz and a GTX 1080 Ti.
And the slicing process takes like 3 seconds.
But I have also used older PCs and this process can take very long.
Well, so once that's said, we'll open the settings visibility menu clicking in the setup wheel. As you can see, some of the options with a black info signal are disabled, since our printer has a unique extruder. We're going to activate the line count feature as well, so we won't need to do the math every time. Now, if we change this value to, for example, 3, it will invalidate the setting above. Actually, I'm going to remove the wall thickness in millimeters, since we don't really need both parameters. If you hold your mouse over each of the settings, you can read a description of what they do, so I'm going to go directly to the ones I find more interesting. I don't use to change anything in these settings here, till the top bottom thicknesses. Whereas we did with the wall thickness, I'm going to activate the top layers and bottom layers options, what will allow us to change the number of top and bottom layers independently of the height we chose before. As you can see, I used to set the top and bottom layers to 4 for a better result, but it can also work perfectly with only 3. Next, we find the patterns and directions of the top and bottom, and I'm going to show them to you real quick. If we slice the model and we go to the bottom layer, you can see in yellow that the direction is 45 degrees respect the y-axis of the printer, that's the value by default. You can change the direction from here. For example, if we set it to 90, now the lines will be horizontal. Instead, if we set 0, the lines will be vertical. If instead of lines, you want to use another pattern, you can choose for example concentric, what will make rounded bottom prints look very cool. Or even you could use this contour pattern for the very first layer and maintain the lines in the rest of the bottom and top layers. For this video, I'm going to set the top bottom partner to zigzag and the initial layer to concentric. This way the first layer will look cool and the next ones will be strong without the need of making retractions with this zigzag pattern. I'm going to actually hide the line directions option, since I think I won't use it very often. I'm going to display as well the outer wall inset, optimized wall printing order, outer before inner walls, and I'm going to jump directly to the horizontal expansion setting. We'll use the outer wall inset if we notice a separation in between the outer wall of the printed objects and the rest of the walls. For now, I'm going to leave it at 0. The optimized wall printing order option will in theory choose the closer wall as the next wall to be printed, when we are extruding different bodies. This will reduce the printing time, but it will depend on each print. You can try activating or deactivating this setting. For this use case, the print will take 1 hour and 35 minutes, no matter if we activate this option or not, so I'm gonna leave it activated. I am going to activate the next option as well, and let the horizontal expansion at 0. We'll use this option if we need to make a hole, for example, to fit an ad, and it doesn't fit. This option will offset the gap by the number we set in the text box. Continuing with more options, I'm going to display the Z-Zim alignment, Zim corner preference, and enable ironing. For the Z-Zim alignment, by default it is set to the sharpest corner, but since the Mickey has not sharp corners, I'm going to set it to shortest, what will reduce the printing time in some prints. Here is barely the same, but trust me that this setting could make a big difference in big prints. Next, Zim corner preference is set by default to hide seam, and we're gonna leave it there if we have no issues with the seam in the future. Finally, the enable ironing feature will, as its name says, iron the top surfaces, melting all the lines together and giving it a shiny look. Since the Mickey does not really have horizontal top layers, I'm gonna drop here a 50mm cube to explain you the concept. If we move the layer analyzer to the layer 250, that will be the top layer of the cube, we can see here in the simulator that the top is gonna be printed as we said before. First the outer wall, then the other two inner walls, and then the top layer surface, including the contour and the zigzag pattern. But if we run the simulation even further, we can see that it will start from the opposite corner, but this time ironing the surface. This will extrude a very little amount of material, enough to melt the perpendicular pattern together and getting a very shiny top. Here I have printed this top surface of the cube with the ironing option activated and deactivated, so you can check out the difference. It is cool, right? I'm going to leave this option deactivated for now, since I think it's really cool, but in this particular case we won't really use it with the Mickey Mouse print. Now, as I always do, I'm going to make the print with the settings we set today in the Shell tab. As you can see in this table, these are the new values in terms of printing time and filament, differentiating in between weight, length, and cost of material. As you can see here, I have both Mickeys, the one from today's episode and the last episode's Mickey, that I've tagged as 4 as 5 here in the bottom, since these are the episode's number. As you can see, there's not much of a difference, and we'll see if these changes will make a big difference until we get to the last episode of this series, guys. Finally, I almost forget it, we're going to save the changes we made in this episode, and for that we're going to click here in the Profiles menu and select the Update Profile with Current Configuration option. In the next episode, we'll study the next tab, labeled under Infill, so definitely stay tuned for the next video, guys!
Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects3DP if you still haven't, hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this video so more people will be able to enjoy with this project. And as always, a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp, clicking here in the top right corner, or in the link in the description. Remember that becoming a Patreon, you will get access to all the necessary components for this project, as well as all the past projects in the channel, and much more rewards that you can check in our Patreon page. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video! Thank you.